Hello everyone, welcome to another game of World of Warships. Today's free play is from C.M. Cunningham and he is in the Gacha Mada. And I'm terribly sorry, I'm probably pronouncing that wrong. Now this is a tier 7 destroyer in the Pan-Asian line and he is on the map Trident in a 3-point domination game. There is one carrier and the friendly team has a destroyer advantage, but I also have a failed division tier 4 destroyer. And we will see how much use the Clemson is. Now, of course, he has good concealment, so he can go capture those points. We shall see if he does that or not. Now, Cunningham here has entered the sea cap. He has spotted an enemy destroyer and he is engaging. The Gacha Mada has some pretty good guns. But the friendly destroyer has quite a few friends here. Now he could deploy smoke here right now, but he should drop from vision any moment now once he starts shooting. There is also a convenient island here to protect some cover, to provide some cover. So he is fine, he can now sit here and just capture. There is also, well, this island also protects him from torpedoes. We know where the enemy destroyer went, so it's unlikely that the second destroyer is a, well, the second destroyer is a Pan-Asian. Second destroyer couldn't even hit him with torpedoes, so he should be rather safe here. Anyway, this ship, by the way, was built by the British, transferred to the Royal Dutch Navy, and sometime after the war, sold to Indonesia. Now back to this battle. The friendlies are taking point A without much opposition. The enemy team so far doesn't have a single capture point, and even though the friendlies are here outnumbered, they have successfully taken the point. Now he is launching some torpedoes here and then scrambling into cover. He could go for smoke screen here. I think he will just use this island as cover and engage the Nuremberg. Now if you're wondering why the torpedoes of this ship are not looking like other torpedoes, that's because they are deep water torpedoes, and deep water torpedoes cannot hit destroyers. That's pretty much the difference. Now the enemy destroyer has returned, he has snuck into the cap circle and is now capturing. I'm not sure if there would be much point in returning and going inside the capture circle. And hey, we have a torpedo hit here. He is currently engaging the Nuremberg. There is some help coming this way. So yeah, well, I guess contesting this cap could be helpful, but right now he is taking out the Nuremberg and that's very helpful indeed. There is still some support around for the Akatsuki. And well, while Ilyanda is not in a position to help inside the cap and the battleships might not be that good at hitting the enemy destroyer. Now the destroyer is spotted and barely moving right now. Friendly planes are also incoming. And let's see if he can sink this destroyer. This would be very helpful for the friendlies. And then he can just go in there and retake the capture point without a problem. And come on, just a few more shells. The destroyer is almost dead, but he is now trying to dodge and disengaging. Some other ships are also joining the fun and the Colorado managed to take out the Akatsuki. So nicely done, now this cap is ready for the taking and Cunningham is going there to recapture it. The friendly team still has A without there being any trouble, so when they retake C, they will once again have more capture points. I mean, they are in the lead anyway because they've sunk more ships. Now the Clemson and the Kamikaze, I have absolutely no idea what they are doing. I mean, there is absolutely no reason for the Kamikaze to be where he is. He's probably looking for a carrier, which means he is just wasting his time right now. Because it's just not worth it to go looking for a carrier at the zone wall. You spend so much time doing absolutely nothing that it is always bad for your team. Now, well, meanwhile, Cunningham is retaking this point. He is ready with his torpedoes and he will just try to close the distance towards those battleships and get some juicy, juicy torpedo hits. This ship has 8 km torpedoes, so the Giulio Cesare would already be in range, the Colorado not yet. So he is here launching for the Cesare, I suppose. And well, I mean, he could also go for the Murmansk. Keep in mind that the target that's currently selected by the torpedo launch in a replay is not necessarily the one he had selected in the battle. So it's sometimes a bit hard to see at whom the torpedoes are launched, but I think in this case it's pretty much the Giulio Cesare. Now let's see if those deep water torpedoes can get some juicy hits. The point is taken and yep, that worked out well. Now he does have his smoke ready. He could deploy his smoke here and that's exactly what he is doing and open up with his guns. There is a plane nearby who could provide spotting and I don't know if the ships over there on the left side are close enough to provide some spotting. Otherwise, when you're inside of your smoke, that's always a concern. You need somebody to be your eyes outside. Now this poor Giulio Cesare is pretty much going down. He is on fire now. He has probably used his damage control to get rid of the flooding, so no escape for him. And there you go. Now Cunningham has already sunk 3 enemy ships. It's looking pretty good for the friendlies. They control the majority of the capture points. The enemy team has a destroyer here in the center and I guess he could try to go there and engage that, but right now there are just some juicy battleships to shoot at. And it looks like nobody is spotting for him any longer. So he now has to leave his own smoke screen in order to continue spotting some enemies. Now at this point he could go, well, he could try border center. There is some merit in that. He can also stick around and engage those ships, because if they are pushing in, then torpedoes are going to be really strong if a battleship is sailing towards you. There's a good chance he can just devastate them with torpedoes. Now his smoke is almost ready again as well, so he could just use his smoke once more. Then again, he still hasn't anyone spotting, I believe. Maybe the Budioni is close enough by now. You can see the 2 friendly destroyers here. They are, I don't know, trying to explore the world, but they don't seem to be interested in taking part in this match. Anyway, there is at least a King George they are chasing for whatever reason. Now chasing somebody with torpedoes is never a great idea. Then again, the Clemson isn't a good torpedo boat in the first place. It's a rather low tier ship and we'll have to get really close to make use of those torps. Now meanwhile, Cunningham in his Gachamada has deployed his smoke and he's opening up with his guns, but once more the ship he wants to engage is spotted no longer. Now the Hood is almost here around this island and yeah, I think the Hood is now providing some vision. We have a friendly Colorado here on the far side who I don't know where he is going, but he's, well, he should have the range to help out and engage here. The enemy destroyer is still an unknown. He could be coming here trying to take this cap. He could try to engage the Ryocho, but I mean, he is an Asian destroyer, so he has deep water torpedoes, which means he cannot torpedo the smoke. Well, I mean, he can, but he can't hit the destroyer, so at least that's not a concern right now if he's coming this way. And point A is being captured, so I think we know where the enemy destroyer went. This would give the enemy team an advantage capture point wise. It also leaves the center point rather open, so something to consider, but right now there is a Colorado to take care of. And the smoke is almost gone, so he is leaving the smoke now. He doesn't wanna be sitting still inside the smoke when it disappears. This one torpedo salvo should be enough, I believe, so he's holding the second one back, and yep, that worked out. Now he could launch the second salvo at the Colorado if he wanted to. He engages him with his shells. Smoke is ready again. Might be a decent choice to deploy it right here. The Pan-Asians have... well, I think one more smoke charge and not so much cooldown on their smoke, so the smoke is a very powerful tool for them. And you've got to get used to that, to having your smoke ready so often. Now he is pretty close to that Kirov. He's deploying his smoke now and slowing down for his smoke. Unfortunately, there is a salvo incoming and... yep. That would be it for this battle. Now let's see how the friendly team fares here. He had a pretty good battle. He unleashed the Kraken and got, well, the same capture points twice. Unfortunately, the friendly team is now currently... well, I mean, they had points twice, but they only have one capture point. And it's pretty close on ships, but let's speed this up and see how the friendlies are going to deal with those ships here. The Kirov is almost down and should go down momentarily, I suppose. We have some planes incoming. There goes the Kirov. The King George... well, the King George is probably eating some torpedoes, and there goes the Georgie. Now, Independence is mercilessly hunted down. He is able to dodge those torpedoes, and... well, the Kamikaze spent all this time hunting a carrier. Will he be able to sink him? Nope. He... oh, yeah, he did, with his shells. Anyway, so that leaves the final enemy destroyer who... yeah, let's crank this up even more right now and see the fate of the last remaining ship. He is hiding here, he is going inside his smoke. Will that help? No, it will not. Now let's take a look at the results. CM Cunningham managed to get 2421 base experience. Nicely done by him. So he went to the Charlie point, he was outnumbered, but he managed to capture it, later recapture it and defend it for quite some time. Cunningham earned himself Arsonist, Kraken and High Caliber. He scored 136,000 points of damage. So nicely done by him. In the end, if he deployed his smoke a bit sooner, it might have saved him, but you know, he was crucial to this victory. And it was a nice game. It showed one of the new Pan-Asian ships. So I hope you enjoyed watching this, and I'll see you guys next time.